Hello everybody and welcome back to the Arrtx. I got this mail in the post basically after the success of this video that I made with the Mia gouache paints. The company decided to send me a bunch of random art supplies that they recommend, and I was like, heck yeah, give me some free art supplies. So I'm gonna test them out and let you know my honest opinion on them, and let's see what they gave me. Hopefully they sent me some good stuff. Pesto's here, by the way. She always comes here when I film because I think she thinks I'm talking to her. Also, there's a box here, so she's gonna be like, what's in there?
Excuse me.
Yes, you're very, very cute. Well done. No. Okay, so let's see what we've got. Ooh, and straight away I can already see that we've got some acrylic paint markers which look awesome. And they're non-toxic, acrylic paint, water-based, which is really cool. And look, we've got so many colors. These are obviously contenders for Posca or the Molotto pens, so it would be good to compare them. They do have some very nice pastel colors here, which I'm excited to try. And it looks like they have a gold shimmer and a silver metallic one. We also have these same similar feel water-based non-toxic pens, which are metallic, which is interesting. Well, those look really nice. I really like the packaging. And look, they've got like nice postcard. These are really cool. Yeah, looks like you've got a couple of duplicates though. Like these colors look the same as those. Double the pens, it's not really a problem, is it? Hopefully they're good. And lastly, we've got some, we've got some watercolor brush markers. I've used these before, not this brand, and I really like them. So let's get trying these out. Look. We've got loads of different colors, which is really cool. Pastor, you need to calm down. I'm looking forward to trying these. I can't believe somebody just sent me loads of art supplies for free. This is really exciting. Paul Rubens watercolor sheets. So this is very nice. I've seen this before advertised and I was thinking about buying it myself. This is really nice to receive. That's awesome. This is 20 sheets, 300 GSM. Which obviously the water retention that can take. It's a watercolor block, so it can take a lot of watercolor. And these are the things that we've got, and Pesto really likes them. So let's get trying them out, shall we? This is probably the thing I'm most excited about, the paint pens. And then what else? And the sketchbook maybe. These are like really interesting items and I will definitely give them a whirl. But this is the main game for me right now. So I'm gonna try them out once Pesto has an app. So let's get started. Right, so first of all, I decided to use the new sketchbook because I thought about using my sketchbook that I've just started, but I thought it would make sense to use all the items that they gave me together to try out because a lot of these art supplies are water-based. It made sense to use this watercolor paper. This had some ridges in it so you could tear it like a postcard, which I found was really interesting and fun. You can just rip out these pages, but also it's not like an annoying, some people might not find that annoying, but when they have a spiral bound sketchbook, I don't really like that because if you ever want to take the pages out, then you have all those marks. I guess you could cut it off, but I don't know, it's just something that I don't really find that pleasing, but if you like that, you like that. This is interesting because you can just tear it out and it looks about the size of a postcard and you can probably send it off to people or frame it quite easily. And I don't know, I like that little aspect of this sketchbook and I think it was really useful. The paint pens are really nice. They were a lot more watery than I'm used to and seemed quite different to the Molotto and Posca pens. Although the colors match was very similar to a Molotto pen that I had, which I found interesting to say the least, because it's just the two dark greens, they completely matched each other, which was quite nice. I guess it's kind of a dupe. If you wanted to get these paint pens like the Molotto ones, they are probably about a third of the cost. So these paint pens retail for about £23, which I assume is about less than $30, possibly more, I'm not quite sure. That's super cheap for 24 of the paint pens. It's less than a dollar each for each paint pen, which is surprisingly cheap compared to its competitors, really. The main thing that I noticed about these paint pens was that they were quite watery, but I think that they worked well. They took a longer time to dry, that's for sure, than the Poscas or the Molotto, but they did the job. So, you know, if you're on a bit of a budget, I really like the way that they look. They're really satisfying with their like see-through case, and I don't know, it's just something about the packaging of this pen that is quite nice. And yeah, some of the paint was a little bit separated in some of them, but I think if you just mix them up they were fine. And I just swatched them out to have a little bit of a go at them, and decided to just go ahead and paint something like I would normally do with the Posca or the Molotov. I just wanted to paint a, well, paint a quick scene, and I decided on this mountain-esque scene with a yellow house in the background because I think it would give me a good chance to layer these paint pens. A really useful thing about these is that they are really opaque, so layering them is one of the main features of paint pens. And this sketchbook is quite a thick, substantial paper, so it should have been able to take all this ink and paint, and it did. It really did. The sketchbook works really well at holding material. One thing I would say about these paint pens is that they do leave a bit of a texture, but I think that's might be a little bit unavoidable with the use of acrylics in a pen. You're probably going to have a little bit of texture, but hey, if you like texture in your work, then maybe that will help you. Here I am trying to layer all the paint down, and the yellow I had a hard time layering because it was a little bit thin, so I had to do a few layers of it, but then it wouldn't dry fully. I had to keep trying to layer stuff down, and being impatient like I am, I don't think I waited enough time for each layer to dry. So each time I tried to put a new paint down on top of the yellow, it kind of smudged a little bit and didn't really work. I do go back in later, like I've just filmed this over a span of a few days, and it did work. So it just needs time to dry, I think a little bit more time than my impatient persona can handle. So that's the only downfall of these pens. But as you can see, I went back in with other colors and I layered them quite well. There's light colors working over dark colors, so they do work. It's just that you have to be more patient with the material, and that's basically it. I guess you get what you pay for, so if you pay a third of the price, then you're gonna be sacrificing something in that area. But yeah, they worked out all right, and that's the finished piece that I came up with for them. Next up is the watercolor brush markers. Now I have used watercolor brush markers before, but I have not used these this company's before. And yeah, they came in this massive stack of different colors, which I found quite overwhelming at first because there was 48 of these colors, and they are priced at £17, which is probably about $20. So again, pretty good price for what they are. And already I just tested these out and I found out that these watercolors are basically what they say on the tin. They are watercolor pens, and I found it really nice because I've tried watercolor pens before, and where they've been like quite nice and flowing and juicy, as we say, these ones were just even more so. Like, they were very watercolory. Like, when I put the color down on the paper, it felt like I was actually painting with watercolors in the sense of the way that they looked. They looked like I had taken a brush and I had layered it down with a brush, and I found that really, really nice. They were just really convenient and useful. I can see taking these on holiday or going outside and drawing with them a little bit more. They take a little bit longer than it would to just actually watercolor, because you're just coloring in with pens really, but they have a really nice effect and quality to them that you can't really deny. And I think it works really well because they blend with each other. They take a while to dry like the paint pens, but I think it works to its advantage because you can take moments of blending them atop of one another like you would with real watercolors, and I think it gives that aesthetic of actually being painted with a brush and water, and that's pretty cool considering they're pens. I would say that the barrel of these pens feels a little bit flimsy, but then again, like I said before, with the paint pens, when you sacrifice with price, you get something in return that isn't perfect, but it's still really good. And I think these are really affordable, really nice watercolor pens. If you want to try some out, I think these are pretty good. I really enjoyed making this piece as well. I just decided to draw a woman looking up at the sky because I'm obviously myself dreaming of a holiday, and I was just imagining what it would be like to just be in this beautiful blue ocean. And I wanted to do something water because I knew I wanted to blend a lot of different colors into each other, and it just makes sense with water, and at least I hope it makes sense. Maybe it doesn't make sense to anyone.
I think what happened with these colours though is that when I looked at them in the box, I felt a bit overwhelmed because there were just so many colours. I was like, I don't know what to use. And just looking at the bottom of the colours didn't really give me any inspiration. It wasn't easy to just pick out colours. So what I did is I separated all the colours around my desk into their different groups, like the blue, greys, greens, pinky, oranges, purples, and browns. And I think that really helped me to decipher where I was going with this image, because I was like, okay, this blue, and then this blue. And I liked that they had an array of colours within colour groups, because then I could pick up a blue and then I could use a slightly lighter blue and fade it out a little bit. And I really liked that idea of using a dark colour and then sort of blending it out with a lighter colour. Now obviously you do run the risk of staining the tip of the lighter colour pen, but actually they kind of clean themselves as you go along with it. And I thought this was really nice, and I thought they worked really well, especially considering they are only £17, which is crazy to me. Next up, I wanted to use the metallic pens. I've never really been a huge fan of metallic-y things like paints and stuff. I've just never really been interested in them. I like glitter and things, but I'm never sure on how to use them within my paintings. So I was a bit unsure of how to add this, or even if I was going to do a separate piece. But then I decided to just give them a whirl and try them out in this sketchbook, because I thought, let's see how they mix together with the watercolor. I also used a bit of white paint pen in this image as well, because that's how I work. So I think it was useful to see how these art supplies would work with each other, and I think they worked really well. I'm surprised by the metallic pens. They were super opaque and they were super satisfying, so I had to keep colouring. I think I made a bit of a mistake colouring the front of her face with the metallic, because it looks a bit odd, but I wanted to use it as a bit of a highlighter pen, as in makeup highlighter, not a highlighter. And it turned out alright in the end. I think it's a nice painting, it's really cute, and I really like the art supplies, that's it. And I was actually really shocked by the metallic paints, because like I said, I'm not a huge metallic person. I don't really know how to use metallic art supplies within pieces, but I think this pulled it off, because it just gave the character a bit of a shine, as if she's in this sparkling water, and I really like that effect. So these are all of Arrtx, I think that's how you say their company name, is art supplies. And yeah, I think definitely the watercolor pens were a bit of a surprise for me, because I was more excited about the paint pens, but I think I really preferred using the watercolor pens the best. And then the metallic pens, generally everything pretty good and pretty cheap. So there you go. I don't know, like, I think these are pretty cool. So I wouldn't hesitate to get some more of these things once I run out, unless I get sent some more stuff for free, which is, it's honestly crazy. I didn't expect ever to get to the stage where art companies would send me stuff. So I'm actually really appreciative of it. And I really appreciate you guys, all your support and everything, because if it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't be getting this stuff. So thank you. And I hope that these reviews and tour helped you out in some way. Obviously, again, I just want to say, don't buy this stuff just because I have it, but if you want it, there it is. And again, as always, thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time. Bye.